हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ बाइनरी ट्री। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ बाइनरी ट्री इज एक्सप्रेशन ट्री। सो द एक्सप्रेशन ट्री इज नथिंग बट a variation in a binary tree. Whenever we want to represent an expression in terms of tree, then we can use a binary tree for the representation of expression. That may be postfix expression or that may be the prefix expression. So after representing the expression using binary tree, then you can see all the internal nodes are corresponding to the operator and all the leaf nodes are corresponding to the operands. So let's see in detail how to construct an expression tree from the postfix expression. So let's start to solve the example to understand the algorithm. The algorithm is already explained in my previous video. If you want to recall the algorithm, you can go through that previous video. That is introduction to expression tree construction using postfix expression. So let's see, this is the postfix expression with us, and if I want to construct the expression tree from this given expression, these steps we have to follow. So our first step is to scan a character from the postfix expression. So let's scan a character, first character, that is A, from the postfix expression. Let's take a decision in step 2 and 3. If it is operand, push it onto the stack. Yes, it is operand, so let's push the operand A onto the stack. Step number 3 will not be executed as this is the else part to the step number 2. Let's go for the step number 4 and move back to the step number 1 because we have to execute the step number 1, 2 and 3 till end of the postfix expression. So we are not at the end of the postfix expression, so let's go back to step number 1 and scan the next character from the postfix expression. Is nothing but B. As it is operand again, let's execute the step number 2 and push that B, that is operand, onto the stack. Here you have to keep in mind that these are nothing but the nodes. These are, we are making them as node and we are pushing the nodes, tree nodes, onto the stack. Step number 3 will not be executed. Step number 4 is saying to go back to step number 1 and scan the next character. Here you can see that the next character is nothing but the plus operator. As it is operator, step 2 will not be executed. Go to step number 3 and let's perform these 3 subtasks. That is nothing but if the scan character is operator, perform two consecutive pop operation. First pop node will be attached as a right child and second pop node will be attached as a left child to the operator node or a parent node, and that parent node, operator node, we have to push back onto the stack again. So let's perform the same task. So this is the plus operator. Let's perform two consecutive pop operations, and first popped item, let's attach it as a right child, and second popped item, let's attach it as a left child. Let's push back the parent node or the operator node onto the stack, and now your stack is holding a single node only. Let's move forward for the step number 4. Let's go back to step number 1 to scan the next character. Is nothing but operand. Let's push it onto the stack. Let's check whether it is operator or operand. Yes, it is operand, so let's push it onto the stack. Let's move forward. Don't execute step number 3. Go to step number 4 and step number 1 back for the next scanning the character. So let's scan the character. It is D, it is operand. Let's execute the step number 2 to push that D onto the stack. Same thing we have to follow for the next one, because next operand, next character is also operand. So scan the character. It is operand, and as far as the step number 2 says that if it is operand, let's perform the push operation. So I have pushed it onto the stack. Now let's move forward for step number 3 will not get executed. Step number 4 says it's not end of the expression. Let's go back to step number 1 and scan the next character. So next character is operator. if it is operator, step number 2 will not be executed. Let's move forward for the step number 3 and let's perform these 3 steps to construct the subtree with the scan operator. So to construct a subtree, first of all, this is going to become the parent node. Let's perform the first pop operation, second consecutive pop operation, and let's attach first popped item as a right child and second popped item as a left child, and let's push back the result onto the stack. So your stack will be looking like this. Now let's move forward for the step number 4. As we have not ended with the postfix expression, let's go back to the step number 1 and scan the next character. It is an operator again. So step number 2 will not be executed. Go forward for the step number 3 and let's construct the subtree once again. So this is the multiplication operator. First pop operation is the plus node, second pop operation C node. Then let's form the subtree by attaching plus as a right child and C as a left child, and let's push back the result onto the stack. Let's move forward for the step number 4. As still we have not done with the postfix expression, let's move back to the step number 1 to scan the next character. It is operator again. So it is operator means step 2 will not be executed. Move forward for the step 3. In step 3, construct a subtree once again by performing 2 consecutive pop operation. So this is multiplication operator. First pop item is multiplication as a parent node, plus as another parent node. Let's attach this multiplication as a right child and this plus as a left child, and let's push back the result onto the stack. So your stack will be looking like this. Now let's move forward for the step number 4. Here we have done with the postfix expression. No character is remaining in the postfix expression. So that's why move forward to the step number 5, and at the end you can see that stack will be holding a single item. Single node is nothing but the root node of the expression tree. So here you can see that this is nothing but the root of the expression tree. So let's pop again that root and let's treat this as a tree or the expression tree. And here we can see that this was the postfix expression and this is nothing but the constructed expression tree with the help of stack data structure. So in this way we can construct the expression tree from the stack data structure, from the postfix expression. You can observe here all the intermediate nodes or all the parent node, we can say that all these are the operators and all the leaf nodes are nothing but the operand. So now let's move forward for the solved example 2. Here I have already mentioned that the postfix expression, and for that you have to apply the steps to form the expression tree. For your reference, I am giving you to check your answer. The expression tree, I have given it to you. Construct it and let's check whether you are getting the correct results or not. And this is the third example also I am giving for your reference. So this is the postfix expression, and for this expression, constructed tree will look like this. And here you can check whether your constructed tree is correct or not. So thank you friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment, as well as do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks. The next video of this video series, that also I am providing here, as well as the whole playlist for the application of tree as well as the expression tree will also provided here for your reference. So happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you. Keep watching.